Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel, and welcome back to another DIY video. So today, spring kind of hit England, and it did a 180. We've gone from freezing cold outside to really bloody warm. So in typical English fashion, I am going to start wearing shorts the moment the temperature rises above about 5 degrees. All my summer stuff is actually currently at my parents' house, so I don't actually have much summer stuff other than what I bought recently. I think this is a summery piece, but I have these trousers that I bought on Depop, and I initially bought them to be work trousers, but they're not what I thought they were going to be, but I love them anyway, and I have a real hard time wearing them because it's long and it's wide and it's just a lot of stripes. So I'm going to turn them into shorts, and I can't remember if I've seen it somewhere or what, but I want to make them into shorts with a little like ruffle around the bottom. I think that would look really super duper cute. And there's plenty of fabric here in which to do so. So let's go and try them on and turn them into shorts.
So guys, here's what you're gonna need for this DIY. Obviously your pair of trousers. These are thrifted off of Depop. They are originally from Parisian, but I got these on Depop, I think about a tenner if I remember correctly. A needle and thread or a sewing machine. I'm going to use a sewing machine because it's going to be quicker, but you can totally hand sew it. A pair of sharp fabric scissors. I have loads because I'm not sure which ones are the sharpest. Tailor's chalk, colour pencil, eyeliner, anything to make a mark on your trousers with. A tape measure and a straight edge. I'm using this ruler. I feel like it's going to be the easiest way to get the correct measurements, but as long as you have a straight edge and something to measure with, you're good to go. Let's get started. First, we have to measure how short or how long we want our shorts to be.
So you want to try your trousers on and you want to measure out where you want them to be. I like mine to be quite long, so I think I'm gonna go here, kind of like Bermuda short length. I might shorten them over time, but I think that'd be a good length. The pockets can get around my butt, won't be hanging out, but that's kind of how I want it to be. We're gonna go over to the table and we're gonna cut it.
And to make it a little bit easier, I think I'm gonna go grab my rotary cutter so we can actually use that for DIY. So I'm going to use my rotary tool and a cutting mat to get the straightest line I can. So save this leg because we're going to want to do it for the ruffles. But what I'm going to do to get identical on the other side, I'm just going to fold it over. And then here we have our shorts. Now I'm going to add a ruffle to the bottom so there's no need to hem at the bottom. I can put this to one side. So now taking our leg, we're going to want to cut 4 identical in width ruffles. So I think whatever size I just had there, how long is that? So I think about 10 centimeters is going to be good because we use about 2 centimeters of seam allowance. So yeah, I think that's perfect. I want to cut 4 10 centimeter strips and I'm gonna see how much I can get out of one leg before we have to go on to the other one. I've measured 10 centimeter strips all the way down, so 10 centimeter intervals, so one there, so like one here. Then I'm gonna line it all up using my ruler. I'm going to slice that out using my rotary cutter. And then you want 4 of these. So you want 4 10 centimeter strips. I'm going to see how much I can get out of one leg before I have to move on to the next one. Okay, so I've cut out all my strips. Now what we want to do is separate one of them at the seam. So you guys can see on the inside there's seams, so I'm going to choose one seam to separate at, and I want to cut either side of that seam, and so we have a long strip. So now we have a strip and we want to do that to all the pieces to make sure one of the seams is still intact. So now I have all my strips, we want to take 2 and we want to sew the ends together, right sides together. So you can pin it. I don't really think I'm going to bother with pinning since it's such a small piece, but you can pin it. I'm going to sew this end together as well as this end, then we're going to give it a quick little hem. So what I'm going to do now, I've got this hemmed, I'm going to do a quick gather around the top here. If I had a gathering for it, that'd be amazing, but I'm just doing some quick gathering. I'm going to do a combination of pushing it through the machine and ruffling. So I've just started gathering this down. I'm just pulling on one of the strings on the top. I've tied the other knot and not on the other side, and just ever so slightly tug it round. So I've got it gathered down. I think this might be a little bit too small compared to the leg. I'm gonna wanna hold it up against the leg and then kind of ungather it to suit that. So now that I've ungathered it to the length of this, I'm gonna wanna flip it and spread out the gathers a little bit more. Flip it. And then put it so it's right sides together, and then we're going to want to sew around this, and I want to kind of maintain the gathers as best we can. And there's not really an excellent way to do this, you kind of just got to watch out and go real slow. So sew around all that, making sure the right sides are together, then we can flip it down and I'll show you how to do the next bit. But first off, we need to sew. This DIY. These shorts turned out so stinking cute. They give me major 1950s vibes, but also like bloomers vibes. But honestly, I love how they turned out. It's exactly how I envisioned them to be. They're actually so adorable. So guys, yeah, I definitely recommend trying this one. You can try it with any kind of pattern, but it was the simplest thing to do. And guys, before we go, a huge thank you to our patrons, because without them, videos like this are not possible. So guys, stay safe, stay dark, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. I held my breath.